Once the new physical planning law comes into action, it means that landlords should brace for construction of apartments or high-rising buildings in cities as the country looks forward to better housing. Authorities will only have to approve building plans that suit within this law. According to the Minister of Lands, Judith Navakova, this will enable better planning for cities, and it's also comparatively cheaper in space maximization. It will also provide the poor with decent housing structures.
Before we had one city, but now we have more cities as a country. And in the cities, there is a lot of urbanization. If we are projecting that by 2050, we could be having 70 or 80 million people, remember that increase in population, but land is static. So we are looking at affordable houses, but going up, high rise. Even my president is particularly focusing on that. The high rise, organized places. Of course, we have the Physical Planning Act, which gates on land use plan. But now, how do we handle the issues of these cities, municipalities? Because they are also a source of
Uganda is faced with an acute housing deficit of 2.4 million housing units, yet about 900,000 units in the country are below standard. To partly address this challenge, the Lands Minister has today signed a memorandum of understanding with Habitat for Humanity in Uganda to build low-cost houses for the public, especially for low-income earners.
For those who can't see here, this is the kind of cemented relationship.
Forward to more collaborations. Now that we are formally here to again commit ourselves as government and to Habitat for Humanity, I can say that as government, we are highly indebted to you and we commit to continuously work closely with you to close the gaps in housing.
Officials from Habitat for Humanity noted that the housing partnership is particularly targeting the vulnerable families and will address the housing needs of 2.9 million people who live under poor housing conditions.
The joy to celebrate the good work that has gone on for many years. 40 years of building, over 40,000 families knowing what it is to have safety and affordable housing and the ripples of impact from that. And a mentor of mine said, the reward of doing good is the opportunity to do more. Now, when I first heard that, it made me a little tired. But it's really important because we know that we have a huge crisis in this country, just as we have a crisis of housing in every other country in the world. Uganda is not alone in that.
Others whose lives are in need of transformation. These are not just statistics. And I guess that is why we can say and quote Martin Luther King when he talks about the fierce urgency of now. There is no better time to commit to making the difference. And that is why Jonathan, Edward, and myself are here to join you in reminding ourselves of why this is very important.
Relatedly, the Real Estate Agent Bill, among other regulations, is also in offing. The bill proposes licensing a person who carries out real estate business. The bill also proposes a fine not exceeding 10 million shillings for imprisonment not exceeding 6 months or both for unlicensed agents. Report compiled by Juliet Namoya for the news.